We're going to say that the third quantum number is known as the magnetic quantum number. And this deals with the orientation of the orbital in space around the nucleus. We're going to say it is a range of the previous quantum number, minus L to plus L. We'll see what that means. And we're going to say it uses the variable M sub L. Now, here I said if we know what the sublevel letter is, then we know what the L value is. We're going to say that our magnetic quantum number, our M sub L, is just the range of our L. What the heck does that mean? Well, if L is zero, is there such a thing as positive and negative zero? You'll realize that there isn't, right? There is no such thing as positive zero or negative zero. Zero is just zero. So M sub L would be zero as well. But when L is one, remember, there is such a thing as positive one or negative one. So M sub L would be negative one to positive one, and all the whole numbers in between. So it'd be negative one, zero, positive one. If L is two, then M sub L is negative two to positive two, and all the whole numbers in between. So the range would be negative two, negative one, zero, plus one, plus two. And then if we go here, M sub L would be negative three, negative two, negative one, zero, plus one, plus two, plus three. I'm going to take myself out because we're going to talk about one more thing, guys. Now, how many electron orbitals does the S have? If you guys remember, it has one, right? There it goes right there. How many electron orbitals does P have? It has three. How many electron orbitals does the D have? It has five. And how many electron orbitals does the F have? F has seven. And you'll see that I just underlined each of these numbers because each of those numbers is actually a label for each one of those electron orbitals. It's a way of describing which electron orbital are we talking about within each sublevel. So P has three electron orbitals, that's why it can hold up to six electrons. This electron orbital would be negative one as its designation. This would be zero, this would be positive one. D has five electron orbitals, and we'd say that this one would be called negative two, this one would be called negative one, this one would be zero, plus one, plus two. So remember that image that we looked at, that page where it talked about the quantum mechanical picture of the atom? Just put these numbers underneath each one of those electron orbitals. That's a way of us labeling and identifying each one of those individual electron orbitals based on their sublevel. So as you can see, the quantum numbers are not just simply separated from each other. They build on top of each other. They're connected to one another. And the more problems we do together, you'll see these connections. Quantum mechanics and quantum numbers can be a bit challenging, but just remember these fundamental principles and it'll help you to better understand this advanced topic.